Hello dear children, it's me Anisha Reginald, Faculty of Science. Welcome to the section of EVS, 3rd Standard, 3rd Chapter, Water, the Elixir of Life. Last class, we learn about uses of water, sources of water and how to save water. Today also, the continuation of this chapter, we are learning about conservation of water. How much water do we use every day for drinking, bathing and other purposes? Can you imagine that? Each drop of water is very precious. Last class we learned about each drop of water is very precious. Don't waste even a single drop. Don't forget the saying, each little drops of water make the mighty ocean. Water is very precious. So we have to save water. And also don't ever pollute water. Dear children, kindly observe these two pictures. Which of the two well water will you use for drinking and why? What is the reason behind that? Just observe the first picture and the second picture. In the first picture you can see, isn't it? The well is not covered with a proper net. Protective fencing is not there. See the second picture, the well is covered with a net, protective fencing is there. So which well water will you use? Absolutely correct, the second one, isn't it? We should keep our well water clean. Most people depend on well water. Wells must be kept clean. There are many reasons for the pollution of well water. Let us find out what are the reasons for the pollution of well water. We should keep our wells clean. These are the things we should keep in mind. First one, is the well covered with a net? Is there a protective fencing around the well? Is there polluted water collecting near the well? Do people bathe near the well? Are clothes washed near the well? Is the septic tank kept away from the well? These are the points we should keep in mind to keep our well clean. The water we get may not be pure. If you don't use pure water, there will be chance of causing diseases, different kind of diseases. So well water can be purified. There are several ways to purify water. Modern equipment like water purifiers are available now. Such appliances are used in houses, offices and educational institutions. This is a method of purification of water. This is three-potted sieve, that is Muchatti Aripa. Let me explain this. Kindly listen when I am reading. Take three earthen pots or coconut shells of the same size. Put a small hole at the bottom of the pots. Arrange the pots shown in the picture. Place washed gravel in the top pot and in the middle pot sand and the lower pot burned coconut shell flakes. So this is a purify method in olden days people used. So keep a vessel beneath the three potted sieve to collect pure water. So now pour muddy water in the uppermost pot. What can you observe children? Yes, the muddy water changed to pure water. Okay, so this is a method of purification of water. Once again, three potted sieve, that is Muchatti Aripa. Don't pollute water bodies. Last class, we learned about many water bodies, lakes, ponds, rivers, isn't it? So don't ever pollute water bodies. The pollution of water bodies threatens the existence of organisms. We all know all the living organisms need water to live. So, it is our duty to protect water bodies. So, dear children, this is an activity. Prepare a poster related to conservation of water. So, don't ever forget. Each drop of water is very precious. Dear children, I am going to wind up this class for now. Thank you so much.